We're at the Atlanta Photo Booth here at Photo Booth Expo 2019. And I've got Steve Lynch here. Steve, yesterday was day one of the photo booth and there were a lot of people in here. Can you give us an overview? What kind of questions, what caught people's eye yesterday as they were walking around your booth?
The big things are, I mean, starting looking at this one right here, one of the big questions is, can I get those emblems? Everybody loves the little emblems. We do throw them in with a booth when you order them. We don't stick them on for you because we don't know where you want them or whether you want them on at all. But we do include them with a booth. And if you do have another booth and you want the nice laser cut emblems as opposed to vinyl ones, yes, we do make those. And I can pretty much make any emblem you'd like. So we do have the laser cut emblems. That's one of the first things people asked about.
Yep.
The next thing is the LEDs. Can I just buy the base because I have an old style? We have a lot of people that have our original venue pad and asked if they can get the base as an upgrade. Yes, you can. We do sell the base as an upgrade. It is on the website and it has the same mount and everything, so you can actually use it with your existing model. Some of the other little things that we've had people ask about are, for example, software. Naturally, our units do not care what software you use. So you tell us what size iPad you're going to use and we will make you a face for that. So I've made them for pretty much every iteration of the iPad Pro, including older iPads and the brandy new ones. So we have the buttonless new third gen styles as well. So we have faces for everyone you could ever want, including Surface Pro.
Sure.
We're one of the first people to start using the Surface Pro in the pad style units. And the reason we do that is a lot of people go, hey, I've heard that the cameras on the iPads are just absolutely phenomenal. And one of the things that's kind of a little bit of a misnomer is that the iPad's rear-facing cameras are absolutely amazing, but the front ones are still a selfie camera. So they're not going to be on par with the DSLR naturally.
Sure.
What we've done is we've gone to the Surface Pro and a Logitech C920 camera, which allows you to basically put the quality camera of the rear-facing camera onto the front of the unit. One of the other things is that allows people to not use software which is subscription-based, which some people think is a plus, some people think is a minus. But for those that do not like paying per use or in a subscription model, you can use something like Darkroom software, which you can purchase one time,
yep,
and you can use that, you know, to infinitum. So this does use the Logitech C920. It allows you to have the autofocus. It has wonderful light management and stuff like that. So you get a kind of in-between iPad and DSLR type of photo experience. So a lot of people have mentioned that they're really surprised that the images from this were better than the iPad. It's just something that most people haven't considered. So we do make them for each style.
Very nice. I guess I didn't even realize, looking at how thin it is yet, even with that webcam in there. I didn't even realize you had a webcam in there. That's
cool.
Pretty cool.
Thanks.
Yeah. Very nice. Yeah. Very in portability.
Huh, yeah.
That's cool. Very cool.
Yeah.
So what else caught the eye? I mean, I know what I caught my eye, and it's going to be in my featured top 10 picks, which wasn't intentional, but you did something with this rover. Let's go. You got to tell me why.
Sure. Sure.
Because I saw this and I thought this was really kind of a cool idea.
Sure. Well, we've had a bunch of our rovers out recently. I'm from Atlanta and we did have the Super Bowl. So we got an inordinate amount of rental traffic during that time. And we had to actually modify a couple of our personal units to be able to put a message out there. And so I just came up with this little quick LED sign thing on the front. And I wasn't even intending to offer that as an option, but people have all come up and said, oh, I love that. You know, can you get it in this color or that color? So I believe they do come in blue, white, and red. And it basically just gives you an option to put some messaging on the front. So if you don't want the really cool Knight Rider style LED strip, you could get that instead with the LED screen, which will scroll some sort of a message, which is kind of nice for branding or for just putting your name out there or something like that.
And that, of course, is the remote control rover unit here that they got the little remote control. They can make it run all around the room if they wanted to.
Yes, because it is using an aircraft controller, you basically can go 2.4 kilometers line of sight, which is a lot farther than most people would go at a party.
Yeah.
And the battery packs on it, we've actually upgraded them once again. So you now have 1,600 milliamp hours, which buys you close to 10 hours of runtime on this, including powering your Surface Pro and the lights and stuff inside, or your iPad. and the lights on it. So you never have to worry about running out of batteries with this now. Some people have actually told me they've gone as many as 2 and 3 events on one charge,
wow,
which I think is probably pushing it, but it all depends on how much you drive. If you're going to drive nonstop for hours on end, like it was a remote control car, naturally you're going to use a lot more batteries.
Sure.
But for the normal short movements you do at an event going around, you can get so much time out of this, it'll blow your mind.
Let's kind of change our focus a little bit to the back here. You've got your mirror, and I love that table idea where you guys made that into the cover of that into the table. Such a fabulous idea.
Thank you. I can actually say that one was my wife. Everybody hated having to get rid of the cover. I mean,
yeah,
that was one of the things everybody always said is, where do we put this? So we went ahead and we threw some legs on it, and now that's a standard issue item with the booth. It's no longer an add-on. So they all come with table legs. And we do have a video on our site where you can actually see the setup and see how that goes together. But when you remove the front, you just fold the two legs out, and you now have a printer slash props or whatever type of table. And it is the right size where you can find from any one of the, you know, numerous reputable vendors out there, you can find yourself a nice stretchy cover to go on it and dress
nicely.
So you can even get them printed with your name and stuff. So we have done that. As far as upgrades to the mirror is pretty much the same as it has been. We have upgraded the computer inside, and we have upgraded the size on the TVs a tiny bit. I don't know if there's a huge difference between 40 and 43 inches, but we have done that. It's allowed for a lighter and brighter television. So.
Oh, nice. Lighter is always good when we're mobile entertainers.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That it is. So let's wrap it up here. We've got the Venue Pro. We've done a separate video on this, but what has been catching the eyes of the folks as they've walked through with that?
Everybody loves the fact that they don't have to drop their cables through it anymore, and the fact that it has the LEDs, because naturally LEDs are going to be, they're just going to be eye-catching. And the cool thing about it is I have it on a rainbow scroll right now, but you can actually just choose a color or whatever. And so if you wanted to have it on a nice pastel pink or a pastel blue or something like that to look nice at a wedding, you can. So it doesn't have to look like a disco. You can make it just look nice and clean and glowy. So people do like that. And you can change the top and the bottom to match, or you can have them doing two different things. So you have full control over your LEDs because they are programmable.
And of course, we did a full video on that where you guys can go check that out and see the functionality and the accessibility with the back area there. That access hatch is going to be a huge thing for a lot of people who need to be able to get in there and set it up quickly and easily and be able to get access to everything back there. Steve, this is kind of a cool layout and such. If people want to find out more information and check out the latest things that you guys are doing with Atlanta Photo Booth, where can they go?
They can go to atlantaphotobooth.com, where we've recently added more photos and videos. So you can find links to things such as the wonderful Disc Jockey Network.
That sounds great. We'll put that link in the description below so you guys can check it out. We are at Photo Booth Expo 2019.